Hello, welcome back, Fidasaind here at Caffeinated Gaming, and today is round 6, game 2 with Scoobyfred27 from the Season 1 Infinity Wars Championships. This is the semi-finals, and we played game 1. He used a deck. I was hoping that he didn't have another deck, so I went and played Bionic Paladin. Theoretically, Bionic Paladin tends to hard counter control decks that do not have Stumble. The problem is, well, he's got an interesting twist on the deck. Thankfully, I have initiative on this turn that really does help right now. Because the Wrath doesn't go off. And right now, my guy's at 7-5, pretty good. The thing is, I have choices to make. I could elect to go and... Yeah, I'm going to drop the Fiery Ram, buff it. That happened, all right. Hit him hard here. I think dropping the Martyr Golem would be pretty good. Yeah, no? Drop the Martyr Golem, thank you. And yes, this video is not live commentary. The game was played around midnight, so it pretty much didn't work for me. There goes my Martyr Golem, that was quick. Although if you look, ooh, I hit him hard. He's low. I'm feeling real good at this point. Actually, I'm feeling real good. And what I'm going to do now is make a huge mistake. Look how many resources he's got. Look. Look how many resources. I mean, seriously, look. Oh, even worse. If I remember right... Oh, no, this isn't... Is this not it? I thought this was the turn that he, I thought he was gonna get Winds of War right there and just be like, ah! But no. I am going to assassinate Aleda so he cannot use Aleda. No, assassinate her, you idiot. Unless, of course, I do have initiative. Oh no, oh no. I didn't see that because I was so tired and at that point I was halfway to being drunk. I could have just used my drones to go ahead and keep me in the game. Now there's a problem. Now there's a big problem. All my guys have 3 health. If I did that last turn, I would have had initiative. Yeah. Yep. That was a mistake. I had the game locked, and that happened. In fact, I probably would have won this turn. For anyone that's wanting to know how to play competitive Infinity Wars, I got a couple of hints here. Do not play when it's late at night, and do not play after you've had like 3 or 4 drinks because you have issues with nerves and you're trying to calm down. So now what do? I got no answers. Well, that'll sort of help. Unfortunately, I probably should have sat back because I didn't have Calamity. Or I didn't have Secluded Constructor. And now he's getting time to draw the cards he wants to draw. Well, that's a good card to have. That'll hit it for 2 only. Because of the event. Really smart idea playing with that event. Mistake to forget about it, though. I actually multiple times forgot about that event this series. Calamity. Good timing on that. I just committed. I'm gonna draw cards because his deck is not very aggressive. Following a Calamity, I can just sit back and draw cards for a while. He's gonna do some drawing, some discarding. He's got a thicker deck than me, so he can sit on cards. Also got a little bit of a morale advantage too. Drop the Flame Ram. Assassinate Aleda. I can stumble whatever blocker comes out and hit him with the Flame Ram then. Maybe I don't want to stumble now. Ooh. So that's only going to hit him for 3 is the real problem here. Should have gotten rid of an unending drone, I think. Unending drones right now are not very useful since he's playing a morale DOD deck. That means he can... Ooh, good, you put it in the attack, actually. Oops, sorry about that. He can just drop the Wrath whenever he wants, and that'll hit everyone for two. I'd rather have a Bad Bot. Bad Bot would survive, at least. Don't need Martyr Golem, because... Yeah, well, hell. I'm also sitting back because of that mess. I figured I couldn't kill him right now anyway, and if he were to drop what he did, then it would hurt me, so that's why I sat back for one turn. Now, I do not even remotely agree with this, because once the Martyr Golem dies, then I have all those guys on the board and taking lots of morale damage. It also worked out that Calamity happened. Well, hell. Drop in Shikana with a drone. That way I could sack to the drones. And try to kill them with Shikanas. Yes, sacrifice that. Unfortunately, he has initiative right now. So if he uses a Wrath, I lose my Shikana. And I lose morale, too. That was a top deck. That was just a straight-up top deck. That was perfect. I could not have asked for a better draw right then. Leaving one drone back so they can start cycling each other if something weird happens. So, let's see. Trade posts. Reflective shield, good call. Use your hit points to tank. It's a very good style of play. Alright. Counting cards, going... Ooh, you still got some more answers. Of course you got answers. That deck has lots of answers. There's a secluded constructor. That might be the key. I'm going to back him up and I'm going to drop an Angelify. Problem with him doing this is he can still mass death. And in fact... Oh no. AoE? Ooh, ow! That was about the worst case scenario. Now I'm in a real tight spot. Because now I have 6 morale and I gotta hit him again. And again, all I had to do earlier was when I had the 3 paladins to play, just buff them when I had initiative. That was it. Winds of War was the only thing that could have killed me, and I let it kill me. That was a huge mistake. I think at one point, immediately after I went and... did I leave them all at 3? I think one of them I might have thought was at 5 at the time. I'm second guessing my turns. So now I'm at 2. Well then, I got plenty of health, so I don't need to really deal with Aleda in terms of fighting her off. But I need to make sure I can do something in one hit. That wasn't it. I need to make sure I can kill in one hit. I'm just going to stumble it later since I have to get down one of the cards anyway, so may as well. One thing is, since I stumbled it later, it probably looks suspicious. Probably assumes I was going to bring out a paladin. And since he has initiative, he probably also knew that I wouldn't be angelifying it that turn. So I should probably think he's probably going to Calamity. See, one, two. I probably should sit back and say, if I were Scooby, I'd Calamity right now. And not play anything. We'll see if that's what I do. Do not need anti-air missiles right now. Don't even really need Fire Blast either. He didn't bite, though. Does that mean Scooby doesn't have a Calamity? Or does that mean he can be passive? Not quite sure. I guess that was insurance in case I did have some Flamed On Aspirants. I can definitely say I probably should have had a few at this point. Right now I'm just looking for the right combination of cards to set up a one-turn smash, and it's just not happening. Didn't discard the Firebolt, basically useless. I need something, though. That's my only hope, is that I gotta set up one turn of just, there we go. There we go! And also, again, I played this deck against someone that was not using Varor, so I took out the Fiery Resolves, so they're not in the deck right now. I don't know if that cost me some, that really hurt me or not, but if you're gonna play Flame Dawn, don't skip those. Have at least one or two, just because in a late game they could save you. Alright, we're gonna assassinate her. I'm trying to make it look like I'm setting up for an attack so he has to feel like he has to Calamity. That's what I was thinking. There's my Angelify, that's good. And I'm also thinking at this point I should put down one of my Secluded Constructors as bait. I really want to bait out that third Calamity. If I can get that third Calamity, I could probably set up a turn that will let me do a one-shot move. That's really my plan right now. No, you... I told you, at this point I'm probably halfway to drunk. I don't know how many times I forgot about that location. I have no idea how many times I forgot about that location. The right move there was going to be to drop a Secluded Constructor. I'm running out of time again. This is what his deck does. It forces you to make moves you do not want to make. One Calamity. Two Calamity. Yeah, two. And Wrath also. So again, all I need to do is drop one Secluded Constructor and then sit back. Set up the right combination of cards. Force a Calamity. I'm using it as bait. Right now, he's probably thinking, alright, I've got to deal with it, because if I don't Calamity now, he's going to drop a Haste Guy and he's going to do something stupid. That's what I should be thinking. A smart me would be doing forcing that. Do not play too much now. Alright. I don't know why I threw all that stuff at it, but whatever. That was a mistake. Because I knew he was going to Calamity. That was the whole point of that play, was to make him Calamity, to drop the one Constructor. Why did I feed him all those free cards from it? I don't know. I'm an idiot. So right now I'm like, okay, I have one more shot left. Is it set up now, or do I need to wait a couple more turns? Draw anti-air missile. Draw anti-air missile. There's one card I think it's on an anti-air missile. Bad bot. There we go. Alright, I got one shot left. That is to stumble his defender, buff my constructor, and then just hope he doesn't have a death spell. That's it. I have initiative, so even if a Winds of War goes off, my constructor will still be alive. One mass death, two mass death, two mass death. So chances are what's going to happen is he's going to mass death. And when that happens, I've lost the game, but what other choice do I have? The deck is... His deck forced me to make a bad choice. But... Winds of War, Wrath, and Heatwave. He did say after the game he had a death spell in his hand. He was expecting to see an Angelify come out, in which case AoE damage was the right move. But there we go, game two. At this point, I jumped up and yelled. The wife, the dog ran into the room like, "You all right?" The cat ran out of the room. So that's it for game two. Stay tuned to game three. Thanks for watching. See you guys later. Bye.